So this is how we finish the batik piece, basically. After the center image is painted and dry, you can complete the edge of your fabric by taking it off from the hoop, of course. And then this is already dry, as I have here. And I want to keep suspending the fabric, so I'm going to lay this over the paper plate. So this will create like the drape that I want, so I can paint just the edge without having to worry that the color is gonna bleed all over the place. So let's say if I do this differently, if I do it on a flat surface, without the paper plate, what happens is the color, from whatever that's built on my glass table here is gonna tend to contaminate all the other area that is dry that already have the color. So basically, to protect that, to avoid that from happening, it's always a good idea to lay your fabric that is dry, that is complete on the first stage of painting that we did in class. Yeah? So now, when you know what you're gonna do is just lay it on top of the paper towel like this. And then this is the part that you will complete with the remaining fabric dye that you have. So here, I'm just going to finish painting the edge of my fabric here. And see how when I apply the dye, kind of like wants to encourage for the fabric dye to spill this way rather than going back into the area that I already painted. You have to remember at this point you are working on a fabric that is not quite stretched or taut, without the hoop. So the challenge is to really, keep it stretched, by using the paper plate underneath it as much as possible. And then here I am, applying the fabric dye to the remaining area, the edge of the fabric. And I work on a glass surface, so it's easy for me to clean the fabric dye once this part is done. So for you at home, you can recycle the craft envelope that comes, that your kids arrive in. You can do this part just by recycling that material, so you can protect your table surface. Or even lay like a plastic bag underneath, so that can be used to protect your table surface as well. So I need to create more fabric dye here. So what I did was I used one of these dropper to help me just pinch a little bit of that pink, and then add water. I'm creating a decorative piece here, so I'm just adding water to the palette to create the shades that I want. So I'm starting up with a very light pink, and that's it. Okay, so now when you have to create your fabric dye, let's say when it's done, it's very hard to have it match the first one, because the ratio of water that you use may not be the same when you make the second batch, unless you really measure it. So in this situation, you may just have to gauge and then see that if it's the right consistency. If not, you can always go back to the first area here, and kind of blend the two colors from the first and the second batch together like this. So I want to be careful because I don't want the color to seep back in like here. You see how it's slowly, getting to the area that already dried. So you want to take your time to apply the fabric dye on the edge of your handkerchief here. And just like you take your time to finish the center part of the image, So the same way, don't rush with the process, because that can affect, how neat the outcome will be at the end. So again, you want to make sure that there's a paper towel that help suspend make sure that the center image is not touching the surface as you paint the edge. I'm almost done with this here, and I want to add a little bit of a darker shade around it because I have a little bit of a blue color on the edge of my fabric. how you paint the edge of your fabric, okay? Purplish ombre at the edge of my fabric. So how do I do that? So I have the basic of pink on my fabric right now. So I'm just using a little bit of the turquoise, lightly here, and same thing just on the edge of my handkerchief here. Kind of want to control a little bit how much, you know, is on it. So I don't want to be, I want to keep it as, you know, the pink on the edge as much as I can. See how I'm using my paper towel to dab away some of the color. Okay, and then here, just a little bit. So the important part is just to kind of to understand. You want to protect the surface that you're working on, yeah, because this fabric dye can stain. So you can put plastic paper, yeah, even get your garbage bag to line the top surface, yeah, of your table before you do this process. Just adding a little bit of blue, and then that blue is going to interact with the pink to give me the hue that I want. And you can do this the same way with the remaining color that you have. Yeah, so the dragon fruits is the one that gives you the pink shades, turquoise added to the pink will give you like the lavender-ish kind of finish that you want, to add. So now I notice that on the edge here is a little bit tricky to get, so just go over again with the fabric dye and saturate that area again. What happened is, as you notice, the edge here is kind of like at a slope. So what happens is the fabric tends to curve this way. So you want to spend a little bit of time kind of do like a little touch up just around the line, the hoop line here. Okay? So how it help you is that it will make sure that when this piece dry, yeah, the color on the edge is even, if that's the look that you want. This is a decorative piece, meaning that when I iron this piece, the heat will make that shades of pink around it even darker, so even brighter. And if I want to control that brightness a little bit, you see how now I'm going to go back and just dab away some of that pink shades, just so it's not too bright. Because I don't want to compete with the color that's already on the image here. Just a soft pink purplish hue at the edge of the fabric. There you go. Yeah, while I do that, I can also, you know, just thin a little bit so it's not spilling all over, and let that dry. Okay? And then I'm going to show you how to iron the complete piece.